हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट एंड वेव पार्टिकल ड्यूअलिटी। सो रिमेंबर स्टूडेंट, फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर दिस एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर और फॉर द इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री और वी कैन से फॉर द क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स। So, what does this photoelectric effect tells us? So, photoelectric effect, first we will see the introduction. Planck introduced the idea of quantized energy to explain the black body radiation that we have seen in the previous lecture. That Planck told that energy is absorbed or emitted not continuously, but it is absorbed discontinuously in the form of packets called as a quanta. That means he introduced the quantized energy concept. The next significant evidence that supported the quantum mechanics comes from the interpreting the photoelectric effect using the new model. The photoelectric effect refers the emission of electron from the surface of some metal when illuminated with the light. So the statement of photoelectric effect is when a beam of light with a frequency equal to or greater than a particular frequency called as a threshold frequency is allowed to strike the surface of metal, the electrons are ejected instantaneously from the surface of metal. So, what does this photoelectric effect tells us about? So, it tells that when a light radiation or a beam of light is incident on the metal surface, what happens? The electrons are ejected from that surface of the metal. But when that electrons are ejected, it is not ejected immediately after the when the beam of light collides on the surface of metal, but when that frequency of light is equal to or greater than that particular frequency, and that particular frequency is known as a threshold frequency. So if the frequency of incident radiation does not matches the frequency of threshold frequency of that metal, the electrons are not ejected at all. But as soon as the frequency of that beam of light is equal to or greater than that threshold frequency, then the electrons are ejected instantaneously from the surface of metal. Is it clear? So this is the arrangement of photoelectric cell or how it works. So when the incident radiation falls on the surface of metal, the electrons are ejected. As soon as the electrons are ejected, that are attracted towards the anode. And from that, it is traveled to the battery. Is it okay? So this photoelectric effect was given by Albert Einstein in 1905. For this explanation given by the Einstein, he got the Nobel Prize. Okay? So, some terminologies that are used in the photoelectric effect is a minimum specific frequency or energy required to eject an electron from the metal is called threshold frequency or threshold energy respectively. Threshold frequency depends on the nature of metal. Is it clear? So, threshold frequency differs as the metal differs. So, for each and every metal, there is different threshold frequency. Is it clear? The next is, see, the kinetic energy of that radiation as increases, and when it meets the threshold energy, then only the electron is ejected. Okay, so from this point, the electrons are ejected. And below this, the electrons are not ejected. Is it clear? the kinetic energy of ejected electron is plotted against the frequency of the incident radiation. So we obtain the graph as shown in this figure. So this kinetic energy as increases and reach the threshold energy, then and then only the electrons are ejected. So we know that kinetic energy is denoted by Ek, and we know that kinetic energy is equal to, or energy is equal to h nu. Nu is the frequency. Here in the photoelectric effect, nu minus this threshold energy, which is denoted by the threshold frequency, which is denoted by nu zero. So h nu minus h nu zero, when we solve this bracket, this h nu minus this phi, this phi indicates the work function. So h is a Planck's constant, nu is the frequency of incident radiation, nu zero is the threshold frequency, and phi is the work function. So what is the meaning of this work function? So work function is the product of Planck constant and the threshold frequency. So it is the quantity of energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface. Okay, work function is the quantity of energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface. That means work function, that quantity of energy is required. Is it clear? These are the small concept or small things that you have to remember. Okay, the next is the important observation related to the photoelectric effect. First is the electrons are emitted immediately when the light is incident on the metal surface. Is it okay? The intensity of light does not affect the kinetic energy of ejected electrons, but the frequency of light affects the kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. And the electrons could not be emitted when the certain wavelength, no matter what the intensity. That means what? Whatever the electrons that are emitted from the surface of metal, we measure its kinetic energy. So we come to know that that kinetic energy does not depends on the intensity, but it depends on the frequency. That is nu. Is it okay? This you have to remember, that it does not depends on the intensity, but it depends on the frequency of light incident radiation. So electrons are ejected only if the frequency of incident light is equal to or greater than a minimum value called as a threshold frequency. The kinetic energy of emitted electron depends upon the frequency of incident radiation. This we have seen in the second point. Einstein's reasoning demonstrated that light in terms of photoelectric effect behave more like a particle rather than a wave. This is termed as a photons. Okay, so from this photoelectric effect, it was demonstrated that the light is not considered as a wave, but it is considered as a particle, and that particles are known as a photons. The next is wave-particle duality, which is also known as a de Broglie's hypothesis. The Louis de Broglie, a French physicist, in 1924 advanced the idea that like photons, all microscopic particles such as atom, molecule and subatomic particles like electrons and protons also possesses the dual nature. So dual nature means what? That it behaves as a particle as well as a wave. That's why this point is known as a wave-particle duality. Hence, this de Broglie's hypothesis is called the pillar of quantum mechanics. Okay? So what does it tell us? That not only the photons, that not only the light which behave as a photon as well as wave, but also all microscopic particles such as atom, molecule or subatomic particles like electrons, protons also possesses the dual nature, That means it behaves as a wave as well as the particle. So student, these are the most important points in the quantum mechanics, that is black body radiation, photoelectric effect, wave particle duality. These you look as a simple, but these are the main points of quantum mechanics. So you have to remember line to line what is this whole concept tells us, what information we get from this concept. You have to see, you have to learn it by heart. Next, we are going to study wave particle duality, that is known as de Broglie's hypothesis. So Louis de Broglie, a French physicist, in 1924 advanced the idea that like photons, all microscopic particles such as atom, molecule, and subatomic particles like electron and proton also possesses dual current. So the basic concept behind de Broglie's hypothesis is that, as we have seen, that light particles or the light react as wave as well as particle, that we have seen in the wave particle duality. So similarly, or same as like that, all the subatomic particles such as atom, molecules, all electrons, protons has dual character. Dual character means wave as well as particle nature. The wave associated with a particle is called a matter wave or the de Broglie's wave. So this hypothesis of de Broglie is called as a pillar of quantum mechanics, which have a great importance in the quantum mechanics. So now we know that according to the Planck's quantum theory, E is equal to h nu, where h is a Planck's constant, nu is the frequency. And also we know that according to the Einstein's equation, E is equal to mc square, where m is the mass of electron, c is the velocity of light. Okay, so now equating this both, that is h nu is equal to mc square. So what will happen? See, we know that h nu, for the photon, nu is equal to, that means frequency is equal to c upon lambda. So substituting nu is equal to c upon lambda in the equation, so it will be hc upon lambda, okay? So which is equal to m into c square. So I will split that. So m into c into c. So what will get cancelled? This one c will get cancelled with the another one. So now we will find the lambda. So what we will do? We will shift this lambda to this side. So lambda is equal to, what remains here? H upon, this lambda is shifted, what remains there? M into C. Okay. So now lambda is equal to, lambda means wavelength, is equal to H upon M into C. So the mass of photon is replaced by the mass of material particle. So that mass of photon, we will replace it by mass of any particle of which study is going on. And that c, that is velocity of light, is replaced by the velocity of that material particle. So what will happen? Lambda is equal to, it will be like this, h upon m into v. Okay, so we know that m into v, that is mass into velocity, is equal to momentum. So where p is the momentum of that particle. The above equation is known as de Broglie's equation. So remember, whenever there is a question about the de Broglie's equation, you must know that de Broglie's equation comes from equating the Planck's theory and Einstein's theory. That means equating h nu is equal to mc square. which tells that wavelength depends on the or indirectly proportional to the momentum of that particle, where lambda is the de Broglie's wavelength. Thus, the significance of de Broglie's equation lies in the fact that it relates the particle character with the wave character of the matter. So, what is this particle character and wave character? So, wavelength gives us proof that it behaves as a wave. As there is a wave, therefore we can get the information about the wavelength. Similarly, particle character, when we get the momentum, we can find out the moment of only any particle. That means they both relates each other. Okay, and therefore there is a significance of de Broglie's equation that all subatomic particles have a dual characters. So here a point you have to remember, although the de Broglie's equation is applicable to all material objects, but it has a significance only in case of microscopic particle. That means de Broglie's equation is not applied on the macroscopic particle. Okay, these are the small things that you have to remember. Okay, I will stop here. Thank you.